This is Bumper to Bumper TV.
It took nearly a decade before the Hyundai Santa Cruz moved from being a concept to a real production vehicle. In that time, the brand evolved and the execution of the Santa Cruz also changed. We get a week of seat time in it, and that is how many features got a much-deserved second look. One thing that makes it stand out is the question we got a lot during the test drive. Is it a truck, and who makes it? The correct answer is it's a sports activity vehicle. While that indicates it's closer to a crossover, the Santa Cruz can also do some work. Our test model was equipped with a 2.5-liter turbocharged engine. It comes with an impressive 281 horsepower and 311 pound-feet of torque. Remember, it's built on the same platform as the Tucson crossover. The transmission is an 8-speed gearbox with a wet dual clutch. Considering it's an all-wheel drive configuration, it manages the engine output without protest. The transaxle can be controlled with paddle shifters, which prove to be very responsive in day-to-day driving situations. Speaking of driving, the Santa Cruz operates on paved roads at a surprisingly quiet level. With the turbo-assisted engine, it proved to be more than capable in expressway driving, while easy enough to handle in stop-and-go gridlock. The Santa Cruz also makes good use of space, with a storage area below the cargo bed and a smaller cubby built into the side wall. This is a space big enough to hold tools or a set of jumper cables. In addition, there's hidden storage under the rear seat. We noted earlier that it shares the same platform and drivetrain as the Tucson. In terms of handling, that translates into a unit which is very easy to maneuver in tight spaces. It arrives at a time when there is at least one other competitor in this unique segment. Maybe it will prompt other automakers to come up with their own version of this kind of urban sport activity vehicle. I'm Greg Morrison.